Get ready to be more productive with your team and save time. With this browser extension, you are going to accomplish that. Now, I'm a sucker for time savers, so I'm really liking this deal. It's called OSlash, and I'm going to show you how it works right now. What's up, everyone? My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. Before I get started, I want to let you know that there's a limited time deal going on right now, so you don't want to miss out on it. That link will be provided in the description. Now, this is the main page for OSlash, and I do recommend checking out this video because it's funny, they got good music, and it shows you around the tool. So, enough talk about that. This is available for all browsers, and in my case, I have it installed for Chrome browser, and it's this little icon right here. What does OSlash do? Well, it helps me shorten links so I can find them later on. Now, heads up, this is not a link shortener. It doesn't have to do with that. These are shortcuts to find these links really easily. Now, let's just say that, for example, I'm on this Slack page, okay? And we got this link. I mean, I'm not going to remember that link. And if I share it on Slack, on Zoom, or email, go finding that link, it's pretty hard. But let's just say that we have to constantly come back to this link, myself or my team. Well, all I have to do is click on this Chrome extension. This is the link, and I'm going to give it a shortcut. So in this case, this is a Slack, and this one is for Atsuma, all right? There we go. So I can name it something like that or make it something more simple if I like. In this case, I'll keep it super simple. I'll just say SA, that's all I'm gonna use. Description, and I can add tags to this. Now in this case, it's public, so if my team members have this shortcut, they can also go to this link. I can make it members in the workspace or make it private, all right? So only me. Let's go ahead and save this, remember SSA. So go ahead and do that. There we go, it's been created. Now, what can I do with this? Let's go ahead and open up a new page. I'll click the OSlash and I'll put SA. Hit enter. Boom, well, I'm here already. Okay, so I'm here. I'm in the Slack page that I just made the OSlash for it. So it's super fast. And if my team members have that link, they're gonna go able to go that link super easily with that shortcut. So I don't have to search around for this particular chat if I'm always going to this. Now, same thing goes, for example, if you have a Google Sheet has a really crazy link. Imagine you got 30 Google Sheets or 100 of them, and if you type in docs.google, you're not going to find it. You're gonna have to go into Google, go to this little icon, and then go to this page. Well, why don't we all slash this thing, all right? Let's go slash it. Let's just say sheet and video, sheet video. There we go. Let's go ahead and save it. Right now, I'm not going to tag anything because I just want to show you how easy this is. Again, new tab, I'll go like this and I'll say sheet video. There we go. I'm here that easily. So that's one of the ways that you can do it. Another way would be, for example, I'm on Mac, so I'm going to hit Command J and it's going to open up the search bar. If you are on Windows, it's going to be Alt J. All right. So inside of here, I can also use this as a search one. For example, whoops, right here, sheet. There we go. I got my sheets right here. Or I can use a shortcut also, like this, find shortcut, tags, actions, tabs, and history. So just super easy with this extension. I really like it because it's going to save me time to go to these certain pages that I don't remember or just makes it easier. For example, I constantly go and I type in Facebook and I have to hit space, debugger, to go to this page, and then I go to the actual debugger page. Now, I'm actually doing that constantly. This would be more easier with OSlash than just saving that page. So for example, I can say FB debug, right? That's gonna be my OSlash shortcut. Now I don't have to remember or type that in and go through all that process or save it with a, what do you call it? With a favorite link, because this is much faster than favoriting it this and bookmarking it. So that's one of the things that I like about it. Plus you have your panel right here. Let me refresh it. These are the ones that I've created already. For example, I got one for Switchy. Before this, I used to type in SW on my browser and it'll take me to Switchy. But what was it doing? It was going to the main domain and then it was redirecting to my panel because it's a different link. So in this case, using this shortcut, it's gonna go directly to the link. It's gonna open faster and it's gonna go to where I wanted to go super easily. Now you're gonna view a list right here. You can favorite these, you can copy them, you can share it, and it's super easy. Plus, this works everywhere. Let's just say that I am on, I don't know, Gmail. Let me go ahead and open up a Gmail. There's actually one already created for this. So new mail, oh, new mail, right? Oh, new mail, let's go. Okay, so this is my Gmail. It just opened it up and it's compost mail. OSlash works inside of here too. So for example, if I wanted to share a Google Sheet link, so I'll just put OSlash and I'll just say sheet, and here's one of my sheets. I can go ahead and grab one of these, and there we go. This one already has the link inside of it. So that was super easy to add with OSlash. Like I said before, it's time saving. That's what I love about this. If this saves me time to go to specific links that I go to constantly, and it's super easier than just typing it in, or faster than doing a bookmark, then yeah, it's totally worth it. If you don't care about time saving and you're good with bookmarks, then you're good to go with what you have already. But that is OSlash. I really liked it. And again, I do recommend you watch this video because it's pretty funny and it's pretty cool. But if you guys want to grab the deal that's going on right now, like I mentioned before, that will be provided in the description. And if you haven't subscribed, do consider doing so right now. Well, I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you on my next videos.